Hello and welcome to this Warcraft replay, third and final game of this WC3 series here on the map Echo Isles. So, relatively small map, but I have noticed in the many Echo Isle games recently, it is the longest of the series. So, I have no idea what the reason is on that, but yeah, that's a fact. It's extra bit of trivia if you guys didn't realize. But yep. Most of my longest videos get a lot more views than the average like 15-minute videos anyway, so I guess I can't really complain. That of course doesn't mean I can't, you know, do this in a bad quality, so I have to maintain for about 20 plus minutes. Yay. Okay, 1-1 on both sides. We have Colorful spawning in as the Purple Night Elf player in the top left. That would have been a weird undead, honestly. Fanta is spawning in as the red undead in the top right. So, same colors all throughout the series. That's going to make it less work for me when it comes to doing the overlay. Okay, from what I've run the last two games, It's good to make a good solid bet based on the opening minutes, because that is going to win you a lot of money. So we shall see what happens. I guess I'll start making my prediction on who wins in like 5 minutes, maybe minute five on the mark. Yep, I'll do that. I'll try to remember to do that. So Ghoul opening here. Once again for Fanta. I'm actually really looking forward to making that prediction. Second Ancient of War. Okay, so potential Huntresses here for Colorful. Definitely not like Fanta, who remained, you know, he didn't make any alterations with his build path whatsoever. He just did what he did in game one, and he won. I guess the only thing that was different was how he played it, because he was really passive in game one, and that kind of lost him the game, maybe. I'm gonna say that's the factor there. So, Colorful, on the other hand, who did lose, is now changing what he wants to go for. So, Huntresses are going to be put onto the table, maybe. It is a very high possibility, because, I mean, it's the clear indicator for a follow-up on the Warden. We'll see. I mean, we're definitely not having double archers. I can't imagine that working out too well. But we don't have a Hunter's Hole, which is weird. Okay, we're going tier 2 instead. I guess it wasn't as clear of an indicator as I claimed it to be, so we're not going to have Huntresses. I don't know what that thing in Ancient of War is then. To be completely honest, I have no idea what this guy is for. What are you for? I have no idea. I mean, we're still making archers, but we're not making archers out of that second one, so it's either there for protection, maybe. I don't know, that's a weird thing to say, because yeah, there's something called towers, and they're actually pretty good at defending. I guess Colorful is just gonna use two Ancient of Wars to creep. Alright, Warden abusing this pretty nifty thing here, but well, the Warden just realized that the trapper moved aside, so can't really do that trick anymore. Pretty badly timed there for Colorful. It was just really unlucky that it coincided with Fanta's presence. So he's gonna clear out this creep camp and maybe claim the item which drops from the Magi. Okay, the Warden is now here. It's probably going to be risky to stay put. The item was picked up by the Death Knight, so 15 second vulnerability potion, but the kill was given over to the Warden. So it's 50-50 trade here, kind of. Ghoul will most likely live. The Warden, probably sad about that, missed opportunity, but oh well. She's level 2, so she can't really expect much to be gained from this. It's actually pretty bad that she's still level 2. Okay, this Ancient of War has reached the Murloc camp. What will he do? Definitely not start now. Shadow Strike will maybe kill that ghoul off. Yep. Level 1 Death Coil is still not that super fantastic in terms of healing. So, I mean, it's not to be expected that you will lose some units despite tossing out those Death Coils. Yeah, I'm still befuddled by this second Ancient of War, to be honest. Tier 3 on the way, double Ancient of Lores has been popped down. Lich has been popped out for the undead player. Fantafiction is going for a tier 3 as well. Just left and right. They're going the same thing. Colorful on the other hand. I mean, even though I did say that it could be Huntresses that he's going to change, that's a lie. He's just going the same thing. Except he just added a second Ancient of War into his build order. So the Warden probably will reach level 3. I don't know if that Ancient of War picked up one of those Murlocs and leeched that experience. That's pretty bad if it did. Oh god, I completely forgot to make that prediction. I am going to predict that Fanta's gonna win, just purely on the fact that, like, the Warden, I think the Warden works if she like, is super ahead in terms of levels, but, like, the Warden is very much the same level as the Death Knight right now. So, I'm going to assume that Fanta has this in the bag, even though it's still pretty far away from the actual end of the game. I say it's pretty far away, but both players have hit tier 3, so this is most likely already late game. Okay, plus 6 claws. It'll do alright. The Warden will be pretty potent, alongside with that Orb of Venom that she absolutely must pick up. Talisman of Evasion's probably not that useful. It'll be obviously useful when it comes to clearing out these creep camps, because it's always nice to dodge that extra bit of damage, but when it comes to dealing with your undead opponent, it's not going to be that useful. We have picked up another set of claws of attack there, so yep, does seem like this Warden wants to be the blade master of this game. Ogamola camp is going to be cleared out by who? I don't know. It's going to be cleared out by Fanta. He will pick up, I have no idea what item he picked up. Actually, I do know what item he picked up. I don't know what tome he picked up, in fact. He did sell the potion of rejuvenation, which he did pick up from that Ogre Mauler. Dark Ranger is being picked up by the Obsidian Statue at the tavern, so we're pretty much three heroes once again for Fanta. I still do remember how three heroes kind of screwed Fanta over, because his Death Knight just could not reach level 5. Let's see if it'll remain to be that problem. I don't know if we have destroy form actually just finished, so I expect to see a couple of the destroyers already in the air. We have Blink for the Warden, so really interesting. Not sure if Fan of Knives has been picked up, but seeing as the Warden is level 4, if she does have Fan of Knives, it's still probably just a level 1, which is probably not worth using. Colorful save that Ancient of War. Probably should deny it. Prevent that, you know, minuscule amount of experience from being given, but nope, it seems like Fanta was able to take it down himself. Alright, other than that, they're pretty much passive. The Lich is already plus 14 attack thanks to the Orb of Corruption. He was plus 14 attack, but he sold his plus 9 claws of attack there. I am pretty disheartened that that happened, but I guess the Lich is not really wanting to be a Blade Master. Ah, this is the first time we've seen Colorful do this. So he's going to start harassing the Acolytes. One Shadow Strike, as you can see, is enough to kill off these Acolytes. You know, even though they are sitting on the Blight, Shadow Strike just does way too much damage. Alright, let's see how this will turn out to be, because Fanta only has one Destroyer. Meanwhile, Colorful has 6 Bears. That's an insane amount of bears. Too bad, like, one destroyer is still gonna kill 6 bears. Well, I say that in a pure fight. When it comes to, like, a big fight like this, where your composition's, you know, mixed and all that, yeah, maybe the bears will be a lot more useful. We shall see. These destroyers don't have any mana, so they can't really burn through those bears as quickly as, you know, they would if they did have mana. Shadow Strike there. Yep, no burrowing there for you, little spider. Look at all that. Look at all those tracks. That just shows how many bears are in this game. The Warden did sell one of her claws of attack. I guess it's to be expected, since she does need space for the Staff of Preservation. Yeah. It looks like she's gonna make another trip back to those Acolytes. Definitely forcing your opponent to waste resources to remake your workers is, you know, a nifty little trick there. And all she does is maybe picks off another Acolyte and then TP's back home. I mean, she better TP back home, because yeah, these destroyers should be able to make quick work out of these bears, but the bears and dryads just seem to be stomping everyone. Interesting. Bears and dryads are 1-1 in terms of upgrades, so that's something worth considering there. Level 5, I believe, onto that warden, so that's going to be a pretty deadly warden. Level 6 is definitely her next option. And when she reaches that level, then I guess it's pretty much GG for Fanta. And it's kind of too late to change my decision now, sadly. Actually, I think it would have made sense to put my money on Colorful, because long games will tend to mean level 6 heroes, and the Warden's level 6 ability is pretty good. It kind of covers the flaws that Night Elves have in an undead matchup, I guess. So yeah, probably my mistake there. Fanta is trapped. He can burn a TB scroll if he needs to, but I mean, he doesn't need to, and it seems like Colorful is not really, you know, not really keen on fighting there. Armor supply of 68 on Colorful. Fanta is actually blocked at 60, so there's that Ziggurat to fix that. Fanta is gonna lose a Crypt Fiend there. Yep, and might even lose a Ghoul. He does. So nice, cool, calm actions there from the Warden. The Bears are engaged on a fight. Ancient War also being brought over as well. Dryads are focus firing these destroyers, but since the Death Knight is still, you know, there and breathing, no unit should die unless the Death Knight is out of mana. Oh, Blink being used onto a borrowed Crypt Fiend, but it will still die unless the Death Coil is tossed, which it would be. And then just another Shadow Strike, that's all that needs to be done. There we go. It's like, actually no, I'm not gonna make that joke. That is actually pretty offensive joke. Or not offensive, but just inappropriate. Blink. Blink is just such, it's so simple, but it's such a good ability. So Colorful, he did change things slightly. He's going for more Shadow Strikes and Blinks rather than Fan of Knives. It's understandable because Fan of Knives is just so high cost in terms of mana that even I don't think it's, you know, that great. So it's good to know that Colorful realizes, you know, you can do much more with Shadow Strike than you can with Fan of Knives. Although I guess you could maybe pick off more acolytes with level 3 Fan of Knives compared to Shadow Strike. Wow, Fanta. Okay, that's pretty interesting. Fanta has anticipated this. He's queued up multiple acolytes just for this. He'll lose maybe like a second of mining time there, but that's, you know, it doesn't matter too much. The main problem here with Fanta is that he is spending, I don't remember how acolytes cost, like 60 gold every time this happens. So even though he may not be losing any mining time, he is losing gold. So I mean, he withstood this for a while. I mean, the Warden doesn't have infinite mana, so that's why she went back. Wellsprings is, like, completed, so don't have to worry about being rather sparing with your Moonwells. Expansion coming out for Colorful as well in the bottom left. So this, I don't know, this seems to be, like, an ideal situation for Colorful. He's got a pretty solid army, and his Warden is very, very close to level 6. I guess the only improvement I would like to see from Colorful is, you know, just the decision to go at least to one Ancient of Wind and build Hippogriffs. Because if he does that, he doesn't have to rely too much on his Dryads and level 6 to deal with those destroyers. That's just how I feel, honestly, but I guess he doesn't have to. Crypt Fiend, Death Coil will be tossed out. Death Knight is still level 4, which is pretty much the same thing as level 3, because I mean, you can't get level 3 Death Coil and level 4, so that's pretty much why it's the same. Griffin will live, but it did take quite a bit of damage, so it is forcing a lot of death coils. Oh, disease cloud onto these A-bombs, so I don't remember the exact details on disease cloud. It will deal damage over time on anyone who is in the cloud. I think it also messes up with the regen as well. I don't remember, because it's been a while since disease cloud, you know, has showed up. So there's that. Plus 2 attack for the bears and dryads is also on the way, so they will be 2-2 very soon. Of course, the warden will be very close to level 6 as well, but like, she's been at that state for a pretty long time. Moonwells are going to drop 8 is apply for colorful, which is something to worth noting, but Fanta also has 74, so it's very close. It's getting there. We also have meat wagons in this army composition, 2 meat wagons in fact, so yep, I would have liked the hippogriffs from colorful. Alright, did he Scott, let me read this. Okay, he'll just take damage over time. I guess that means you still get messed up with regen anyway. We have a couple of bears being picked off for some reason. I guess they were just there to deal with those meat wagons, but that was... I'm not sure if it was worth losing 3 bears over. Level 6 on the warden. We have to see that Avatar Vengeance there. But Fanta just... he actually retreated. Okay, so even though colorful like thrown away a good number of bears just to get to those meat wagons, I guess Fanta just got overwhelmed. 4 meat wagons, I think that's a little too excessive. I think we should have just seen more A-bombs, in fact. I don't know if I agree with those 4 meat wagons. The warden, not too sure what her intentions are. She could maybe go summon the Avatar of Vengeance at the graveyard, utilize those corpses there. I mean, she's got to decide, because it's gonna go daytime soon. Okay, how much does she take out? Colorful took out about 3,000 gold. I keep saying she, but that's only towards the warden. Colorful is a he, so yeah, try not to get confused. Lots of bears. But lots of bears doing nothing. Alright, Goldmine has collapsed for both sides in the main base, so Fanta's kind of forced to either go all in or he has to expand. I'm not sure if all in's the right decision here, because your opponent has a pretty well established second base anyway. And Fanta is aware of this. But then again, I guess if he goes like replacement base, it'll be too late at that point. Alright, Fanta's gonna sell this act out with a couple of illusioned A-bombs here. 4 meat wagons and 4 acolytes. Acolytes will be a really nice addition to heal up those meat wagons. Alright, the Avatar is already out. Something worth noting, I believe, is that the Avatar's cooldown is tied with the Avatar's duration, so if the Avatar times out, then you can just summon another one, which is pretty good. Alright, Dark Minions from the Black Arrows of the Dark Ranger. Huge fight here, the meat wagons are being targeted by those bears. Frost Nova being tossed onto them to kind of slow down their pursuit. The bears, you can hear them dropping very, very frequently, but they are slowly pushing away at this somewhat of a front line of the undead player. Destroyers are trying to deal with those bears as quickly as possible, but yeah. Remember, we still have the numbers advantage for Colorful, because he can summon up to 6 Spirit Vengeances. Level 4 on the Dark Ranger, not really going to mean much. We are going to have a Shadow Strike from that blinking Warden. And it seems like Fanta might lose this game. This, I guess, changed my perspective of undead, of Night Elf players. Because I would say that was a fairly close fight. And it's still going on, but I feel that since the Avatar of Vengeance is in game, I highly doubt that things are gonna work out for Fantafiction. Okay, Blink to deal with the last meat wagon, and I think he will be able to. Level 5 onto the Lich here. Will level 3 Frost Nova mean much? Probably not. Alright, Avatar's gonna time out. Where is the Warden? She's going back to base to regen through the Moonwells. Will the Warden summon the Avatar again? I'm pretty sure that the cooldown is the exact same as the duration, so we'll see. I guess it's not. Okay, never mind. It is. Okay, summon more spirits, please. Because that's pretty much the only way you're gonna win this. Fanta's hanging on a little bit with his heroes and 2 destroyers here. But, like, without a base, like, his base is dead. It's desolate. His acolytes aren't summoning at all. I think, already game here. And Fanta's just trying to do as much as he can with this. Actually, no, he's gonna lose his Warden? Oh my god. I won my bet. Yep. That was disastrous. What happened there? So, what? Like, Fanta had the higher score, but I honestly thought Colorful was gonna win that game. So, what basically happened was what happened in the last game. The Warden got silenced. I could have sworn she blinked, but apparently that cancelled a little bit. That was weird. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. I was not wrong. I definitely was 100% backing up Fantafiction.